बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर इज द पाउडर माइक्रोस्कोपी ऑफ द नक्स फॉर्मिका। दिस इज द सैंपल ऑफ दिस पॉइजनस प्लांट। दिस इज द पाउडर फॉर्म ऑफ द सीड्स। इंट्रोडक्शन। साइंटिफिक नेम इज स्ट्रैक्नोस नक्स फॉर्मिका। इन इंग्लिश इट इज कॉल्ड नक्स फॉर्मिका एंड इन उर्दू और लोकली इट इज नोन एज कुचला। इट बिलोंग्स टू द फैमिली लुगेनेसी। इन पार्ट यूज बार्क, सीड एंड स्टेम, बट हियर वी विल डू द पाउडर माइक्रोस्कोपी ऑफ द सीड्स ऑफ द नक्स फॉर्मिका। नाउ फार्माकोग्नोस्टिक फीचर। द फाइटोकेमिकल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट विच आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस ड्रग आर द मेन इंडोल एल्किलॉइड। Alkaloid are the secondary metabolite, nitrogen containing compound. The main alkaloid which is present is the strychnine. The strychnine is the main constituent which is poisonous in nature. Apart from strychnine, it also contains brucine, bumicine, loganine and novacine. It also contains tannins, glycosides and figs dry. Medicinal action and uses of nux formica. This is a poisonous drug, so it is used with very caution. It is actually the CNS stimulant, respiratory and cardiac stimulant drug. It is used in digestive tract diseases, disorder of the heart and circulatory system, diseases of the eye, lung diseases. It is also used for nervine conditions like depression, migraine, headache and symptoms of menopause. Coming toward the organoleptic evaluation of the powder. This is the powder, you can see it. Its color is almost yellowish gray or brownish gray. Odor is fatty and rancid. Taste is bitter and persistent. The drug is poisonous. Now the material and reagent that are required for the powder microscopy are the sample, of course, the sample of the nux formica, spatula, brush, glass slide, cover slip, dropper, compound microscope, iodine, glycerin and chloral hydrate. Procedure is the same as we have discussed in the case of cinnamon, that is to perform the microscopic evaluation, transfer a small amount of sample on a clean and dry glass slide with the help of a spatula, then add a drop of chloral hydrate solution over it with the help of dropper. Now make sure that the tip of the dropper does not touch the powder. Make a smear with the help of needle and cover with cover slip. This smear should be made very gently. Okay, if you are unable to form a better smear, then the observation under the microscope will also be affected. Now quickly pass the slide over the flame in order to fix it. Then observe under the microscope and the cellular feature and note it down. Now compare the observation with the given standard monograph taken from the atlas of microscope. This is the procedure for the first slide. Then you will make the second and the third one also using iodine and glycerin solutions. In the end, observation and comparison with the standard monograph. So this is the diagnostic. These are the main important diagnostic features. And these are the pictorial view which you will see or observe under the microscope. Now I will discuss it in detail. As you can see it, the drug is nux formica, seeds are used. And the diagnostic features, there are the three main diagnostic features, A, B and C. Okay. In the cinnamon, you have seen that there were different the diagnostic feature with the help of which you can identify the powder drug is cinnamon. While in the case of the Nux vomica, you have seen that the organoleptic evaluation of the powder is different from that cinnamon xanthonicum, and the under the microscope when you will observe it, you will definitely look at the you will definitely see the different cell organelles other than those which you have seen in the cinnamon slide. The first one is the Ascalerin chymatis epidermis of the tester. It is a seed, so it contains the tester. So this epidermis is composed of single layer of yellowish brown cells, each of which is extended to form a trichome. Okay, the epidermis is actually extended to form the trichomes. Trichomes are the main features, rod-like trichomes. So, but it is evolved from the Ascalerin chymatis epidermis. The wall of the epidermal cells are strongly thickened and pitted, and each trichome has about 10 narrow lignified rods running longitudinally. The trichomes are usually broken off, and the broken ends of the lignified rods are seen attached to the epidermal cells. This layer is nearly always found in side view. Very occasional fragments are seen in surface view, with the almost circular bases of the lignified rod of the trichomes visible around the periphery of the each cell. So what is the main feature? Ascalerin chymatis epidermis, from which lignified trichomes are extended. The second important feature is the very abundantly fragment of lignified rods of trichomes. These are cylindrical and very considerably in length and thickness. Okay, occasionally more complete fragments of the trichomes are found, composed of about 10 lignified rods aggregated to form a cylindrical structure. So after the Ascalerin chymatis epidermis and lignified rods of trichome, the third one is the endosperm. Those from the outer layer are composed of small thick wall cells, polygonal in surface view and slightly elongated radially in sectional view. These fragments are often found associated with the pigment layer of the tester, composed of a layer of rather indistinct cells containing orange to brown pigment. The greater part of the endosperm is composed of large cells with very thick walls and a small lumen. Occasional cells show faint plasmodesmata in the wall. So these are the main diagnostic feature. Now you will better understand with the help of this pictorial view. So there is the, this is the main view. If you want to look at complete look, that this is the main view. These are the characters 1, 2 and different, and here a description has been given. Now we will study in detail. The first one, which is pink in color, what is this? This is the part of Ascalerin chymatis epidermis of the tester in side view, with the broken off remains of the trichomes rod attached. What is the A diagnostic feature A which you have studied? This one. You can see it. The epidermis with the broken part of the extended trichomes. Now number 2. These are the cylindrical structure. If you look at the description, so this is a part of a large trichome. This is not a complete trichome. This is a part of a large trichome. You can observe it. Now number 3, this feature. What is this? Outer part of the endosperm in section view, the third one. Okay, this is the first one, A part, B part and C part. The outer part of the endosperm in the section view, what is this? You can have a look at it. This is the Ascalerin chymatis epidermis. This is the trichome, part of trichome, and this is the endosperm. These are the main three features. Now, what is number 4? Number 4 is actually an almost complete trichome showing the rounded apex. So number 2 and number 4 are the same thing, but the difference is that in number 2 you have seen a part of a large trichome, while in the 4 you have seen almost a complete trichome. How can you distinguish it from the second one? Because it is rounded at the apex, while this apex is not rounded. So this is the part and this is the whole complete trichome, glandular trichome. Then you can see number 5. What is this? You may recognize it, the fragment of trichome rod. Okay, these are the fragment of these rods. This is the almost complete trichome, this is the part of a large trichome, and these are the fragment of the trichomes. Okay, now number 6, this is structure. Number 6, what is this? Part of a scalene chymatose epidermis of the testa in side view with the part of trichome attached. Okay, this is the part of the epidermis, scalene chymatose epidermis, and these are the extended trichome coming from it, as we have discussed in while we are reading the diagnostic feature A in detail. Okay, the part of the scalene chymatose epidermis with the extended magnified trichomes. Now this is number 7. Number 7 feature is the scalene chymatose layer of the testa. Okay, with the lignified rod, this is the scalene chymatose layer of the testa. Now this is number 8. Endosperm of the central region. This is the endosperm part of the central region. This was also the endosperm, and this is the also the same thing, but the central view. The last one, number 9. Outer layer of the endosperm in surface view with occasional pigmented layer of testa. Okay. These are the pigmented layer of the testa, and these are the endosperm, the same thing. Hope you will understand the microscopy of the nux formica. Dear student, if you have any query, then you can ask me the question. You can post your question to me, and we will discuss in the online class also. So you are free to ask me anything which you want. Thanks a lot.